That's about it for now, Mrs. Easton.
Why?
The department will get in touch and let you know how you can recover your valuables.
You have only mentioned a few of the items that have been stolen, Detective. What else has been recovered?
You see, Phelps, that's why you get the drinks in early.
Hello, Mother. Hello, detectives.
Oh, I'm spot on. Wait, I'm... Yes! Yes! Yes!
Welcome back to
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to that infamous LA Noir, man, where we get the case, we do the detective work, and we spit it in their face right back at them like a bad habit. If you got a bag, you better go grab it. Is that how you guys say it? Yeah, man, I mean, let's just get started. I got nothing else to say after that.
The 187 at 5810 Murata Avenue. Homicide wants you over there. The coroner thinks the broad was whacked using the army morphine. Don't say anything, Roy.
This morphine is just like once they took it off that ship, that thing spread out. Literally, everybody got their hands on it.
Just get over there.
This man's still mad about his $50 from that previous case. I want my money.
What's with that get up?
Like, you don't got a job right here.
Start introducing us as Detective Earl, and this is my science teacher, Mr. Phelps.
Your interest in my appearance is starting to get me worrying.
You don't like my outfit?
We're a dysfunctional couple now. People judge me with you on my arm same way they would a fat broad with a 5 o'clock shadow.
I really hope you're joking, Roy.
You can't take this man seriously. I mean, you know what? I do need to switch it up. I'm not gonna lie. I do need to switch it up. This is kind of clean. I feel like I would like wore that. Actually, yeah, let's wear this. I look like you. Just 10 times more cleaner. Cause you've been wearing that every day. I know that shit stinks. At least I can switch it up. At least I can do that. Where the exit at? I'm low-key trying to follow these signs. I'm not used to the building yet. It's only my third day?
Can't really help me.
Well, fourth day, technically.
You seem distracted. We recovered the morphine. Some of it might be unaccounted for, so what? That's life. We did our job.
Closing one case opens another.
Yep.
Do you have any idea what is really going on while we're wasting our time following this stuff?
Are you going to tell me?
The deal's being done right now will change the face of LA forever, and we're wasting our time on some hump.
Someone's little girl.
Visit the morgue at the end of the month when the John and Jane Doe's are cremated. Their percentages. The odds for and against lightning striking.
This man does not care that all of the freaking morphine is reaching out to all these people. Like, yes, we did stop it from spreading, yes, but it's like, what about the people that already purchased the drugs? Like, who's to say they won't continue on, you know, selling that? About this guy. What is that in the middle? Was that paint?
Second floor, apartment 6, in the back.
Thank you, Thanks. Sir. Second floor, apartment 6. Apartment, that's 5. That's 8, 7. Okay, this got to be 6. I mean, the door is wide open.
Bukowski, you made homicide.
Bukowski!
Good to see you. You two want a hug?
My boy!
Can we get home?
Oh, this
Relax,
here. The boys are back in town. The boys are back.
Cleaning lady, Mrs. Reynoldson. She called it in.
We heard Carruthers thinks.
Carruthers likes to make work for people.
This dude love cutting
overdose
me off.
Overdoses of sleeping pills. Falls asleep in the tub. Rest in peace. Case closed.
Hear, hear. Mal is 100% that it's murder.
Do you mind if I take a look around?
Sure. Go right ahead.
Man, I miss you, Brokowski. All these other guys suck. Possible suicide, Mrs. Reynolds. Okay. All right, so let's take a look around. Who's this? Hello, sir.
Look, I got nothing to tell you, and I can't work with you under my goddamn nose every second.
I don't know anyone under 45 who would wear one.
I couldn't even hear what you said because that freaking guy in my ear yelling. Okay. All these pills.
Looks like barbiturates.
And what are barbiturates?
Barbiturates. What else is rattling around in this thing?
Okay.
We should speak to a doctor. Prescribing both drugs would make her life a roller coaster.
Hold on. What was that I just found? Oh, it's a prescription. Okay. Prescription for a course of amphetamines or amphetamines made out to Juliet Randall in July 46. Julia Randall's apartment. Okay. All right. Okay. Thought there was something else.
Phelps?
Oh my
Val,
God.
We've had a look around. Rusty thinks it's a waste of time. What's your theory?
Come on, Mal. Tell us why we were dragged down here.
If the victim was alive when she entered the tub, water would have entered her lungs. The water is violently churned in the windpipe as she drowns. The result is that a lot of foam is generated. This foam is found at the mouth and nostrils in almost all cases of real drowning. Notice anything about our Vic?
May I take a look?
Be my guest.
I mean, she has marks around her throat, so it's like, was she choked?
Take a closer look at her head and neck.
Her neck That's is what I'm bruised saying. Pretty badly.
Yeah. So it's like, okay, suicide. Got it. Yeah, understandable. Pills to make, like, having all the pills laid out on the floor to make it seem
Very
like she overdosed.
Very unusual ring.
I could be
Look
wrong.
Look at them nails.
It looks like a black sapphire.
Black sapphire ring? Okay.
Bruising on the forearms and these look like bite marks.
That's what I'm saying. Like, bro, was Edward
Eyes
here?
A classic sign of morphine, and the bruises tell their own story. I think one man held her down and another held her arm and injected her. They put her in the bath to try to cover it as a drowning.
And spread a trail of barbiturates.
Take Jesus. A look around outside on your way out and see if you can find the Sorettes. It would make my theory.
And morphine would have been very quick, and there wouldn't have been much of a struggle.
Okay, so find two guys who recently bought Sorettes and weren't junkies, and you might be onto something.
This is her.
Heard you. Can I still look around? Okay, cool. She's something
else. Doesn't tell me anything.
You never know.
Miss Julie was.
Pretty girl like
we
that.
We talked to the witness.
Maybe she was having trouble with some boys, huh?
I'm Detective Phelps. I'm here to try and help Julia. Do you mind answering some questions?
Virginia Reynoldson, I'm just so shocked. I feel like there's something I should be doing, someone I should call.
We can make those calls, ma'am. Who needs to be notified?
That's just it. I don't know. Miss Julie doesn't have any family in town.
I was about
Someone
to ask,
has
like,
to set
like,
her
are you
affairs
to her?
In order. Mr. Henderson, maybe? Who else is there? I don't know.
If you give the details to the other detectives, ma'am, they can try and get in contact.
Who are you? Okay, you're Virginia Reynolds, maid and housekeeper. Okay, gotcha. Hold on, let me look at these evidence, okay? So we got the morphine, signs of forced morphine overdose, according to coroner's Jesus, these words. Preliminary report, possible suicide, men's smoking jacket, waist-length velvet smoking jacket. Okay, sleeping pills. Okay, all right, first question. Victim's state of mind,
was
ma'am.
Was Ms. Randall depressed about something? Upset?
No more than normal.
No more than normal. Can I connect that to anything? I mean, she has a prescription for it, so it's like... hold on. Let me look up this word real quick, because I'm... Under the table, named as Benadryne from the 1930s, 1960s. Its utility as a stimulant was organized during a... I'm gonna just say doubt.
Would she have killed herself for a man?
Miss Julie would never have killed herself. She was a very determined young lady.
Got it
One
wrong.
Of those people
Shocker.
Who shake the tree for all it's worth.
Got, yep, I know. Victim's personal life.
Did Miss Randall have many friends visit?
I'm not sure. I only come around twice a week.
No, I'm pretty sure
Why
that's
are you
a
lying
lie.
To me, Mrs. Reynoldson? Julia had men stay here.
I will not speak ill of the dead. You can't prove that.
How can I prove that she knew about the men sleeping? Yeah,
Who owns
the
smoking jacket?
I wouldn't like to tell tales, you understand. But that's Mr. Henderson's. An older man, very distinguished looking. He seemed very much in love with her.
Sugar
Where
daddy,
would we find
understood.
Him?
I'm sorry. I don't know. He said he lives in San Francisco.
Okay, sugar daddy.
What was it like working for Miss Randall?
Perfectly fine, officer.
I mean, even I know that's a lie, but it's like, what can I connect that to? Perfectly fine. She has a lot of sleeping pills. But it's like, I don't know if that's the right answer. Because all maids are nosy. They're going to look through your things. And depending on how long she's been working for her, I'm pretty sure she kind of, you know, searched a couple drawers. So I'm going to say doubt. I'm going to hit it with a doubt.
Mrs. Reynoldson, it seems like there's something you want to tell me.
She was very high strung. Lovely one moment and screaming at you the next.
Okay.
She wanted it all and she wanted it damn quick. Of course, being so beautiful, it seemed like she was going to get it. Not the way it's turned out, though, is it?
Thanks, Mrs. Reynoldson.
Okay.
You've been very
Thank
helpful.
You.
One of the other detectives will take your statement, and then you can go home.
Yep. Thank you. I'm still going to look around, though. You just never know. What's this? Was that cornflakes? I don't know how people be... Maybe Do people still eat cornflakes? I can't believe that they still selling that in stores. This. Look
this
at the you got
the case.
Rope. Look how the struggle. Is that rope? The struggle is real. How many of y'all have irons?
Don't think this is any use.
Or do
to
you
us.
Guys prefer the steamers? I have an iron. I do want a steamer, but I don't know. Just something about an iron just seems more.
This is all top end of town stuff. Gives us somewhere to look.
Oh, wait, no. Further investigation? There's something in it? Nothing? Okay. Well, I'm gonna check all the others then. How about that? One of these things are not like the other.
Could have been a modeling assignment.
Modeling. Okay. Ooh. Investigate.
It's place to start.
I seen. 6 and 9, I'm working Tuesday 11 to 4 p.m. Come keep me company. Ask for Miss Randall. Julia. Okay.
Beautiful girl. Those certainly aren't from the Sears catalog.
Sears. Can't believe Sears was around during this time. That's crazy. All right. We're done here.
Stefan, Rusty, we'll take a look around outside and then follow up these leads. Can you get some guys to run down
Frankowski,
the jacket?
My boy! Come on, Roy.
You think Carruthers Let's has go. Called it right?
He rarely gets it wrong.
I don't know. I'm with Galloway. I've met enough girls in my time who can't handle their dope.
All right, I mean, I'm not seeing anything.
Are you anything. Drunk, mister? Or are you just cracked?
He better be talking to himself. Julia Randall's apartment, that's where we are. Dr. Stoneman's practice, a scene dress store. Let's go to Stoneman's practice. Commercial clinic of Dr. Stoneman, Julia Randall's prescribing physician. Okay. The doctor that been prescribing those sleeping pills. You gonna let me go? You gonna let me pull out?
Bukowski, Galloway, quite the little reunion in there. Almost brought a tear to my eye.
They're good police.
How I mean, Bukowski
you
know? Is.
You got promoted so fast, you barely had time to learn their names. Let me fill you in. Bukowski's a pushover. Galloway's a drunk.
You could learn a thing or two from both of them.
Please. They couldn't work a vice case if their life depended on it.
I don't see why they'd be any better or worse at it than me.
I notice you said better. Hubris disguised as humility. Kind of your trademark, don't you think?
Why do you always twist everything? Galloway's got nothing to prove. He's been on homicide for years.
And he's welcome to it. You're a terrier, Phelps, and that's what I need. Not some old bulldog who can't get up a flight of stairs without coughing up his lunch.
Oh my gosh, Roy. Go in calmly and just ask some questions. That's it. That's it. Now, what floor is it on? What's his name again? Hold on, hold on. I forgot his name. Stoneman. Stoneman. Okay. Stoneman. That's Coleman. Oh, I was about to say, like, what? Okay, 505. There we go. Fifth floor.
Here, Stoneman, office 505.
Damn, he's so high up. Can we take the elevator, please? Please? Yes! Hell yeah!
I swear, if we locked up every doctor in this town, Vice would be able to work half days.
That's 503. That is 504. 502. 501, 502, 504, that's 503. Okay, here it is, 505. There we go.
Yes, sir, your name?
LAPD. We'd like to see Dr. Stoneman.
Dr. Stoneman is with a patient. Would you like to wait?
No, we wouldn't. Tell him we want to see him now.
There's no need to be rude.
Save it, sister.
Oh my
gosh. Dr. Stoneman, I have some gentlemen from the LAPD here to see you.
Send them in, please. I'll see this patient again after they've left.
Thank you. I'm right here.
Oh, your investigation is much more important than my sciatica. I'm just in pain here. Leave me alone.
Oh, get the fuck out of here with that bullshit, bro. Oh!
Dr. Stoneman? We are investigating the death of one of your patients, Julia Randall.
I'm very sorry to hear that.
Do you mind if we ask you some questions about Ms. Randall?
Not if it doesn't compromise doctor-patient privilege, Detective.
I mean, I'm not finna get into details, because I am aware of that, but...
How well did you know Ms. Randall?
Barely at all. She'd only been a patient 6 months or so.
Okay. This is the only thing we can, like, possibly connect them to, is the Benadryl prescription and the sleeping pills. But my only thing is, I don't know if it's correct. The question was, how well do you know Miss Randall? He says, barely at all. She had only been a patient 6 months or so. And it's not like I know what month we're in now, because on the prescription, it says July 46. I'm going to say truth.
She was disturbed, though.
Well, not in the conventional sense. She had trouble sleeping.
Got it wrong. Okay, so I probably could have just... All right. Additional medications?
You wrote Julia Randall a prescription for Benzedrine. How can you account for that?
Miss Randall was in the fashion business. Mm-hmm. She wanted to control her weight.
She wanted to control her weight. Sleeping pills.
Benzedrine is addictive, as I'm sure you know, doctor.
As I warned her, but she was determined. She said she needed it to control her appetite.
Sounds like you knew her pretty well.
I knew the line of work she was involved in.
That'll be all for now, Dr. Stoneman. We'll be in touch.
Man, this was such... I didn't get anything! Look at your stuff.
Maybe if... No.
What's this?
Nothing significant.
What's this to the right? Can't even look at that. Okay. Hey. You could go back and talk about how sad your life is. Ugh, bro, back up. Where'd he go? Oh, there he is. What you about to do? Just gonna walk past me? I don't trip you.
The old boy is lying.
About what?
I don't know. He looked relieved when you said she was dead.
Relieved?
That's a strange reaction to have to the death of a young patient.
Relieved? Really? He looked relieved? Interesting. Get in the car. Alright, let's go to the dress store.
Have you noticed how croakers only pull out the physician-patient privilege card when they got some to hide?
That is true.
There are certain things people have a right to keep private.
Nah.
Until it gets in the way of police work. And it's only private when it suits them.
Mm-hmm.
A couple of drinks and every doctor I've met will spill your darkest secrets in a heartbeat.
He got a point. Roy got a point right there. Roy got a point. You are onto something with that, I must admit. You guys ever saw the movie,
Good Looking for a Policeman?
It was something along the lines of,
well,
My Darling, or...
What can I help you with today?
LAPD, ma'am.
I hope I haven't done anything wrong.
No, ma'am. We're making some inquiries about Julia Randall. Does she work here?
No, I had to let her go. Is she in some sort of trouble?
She was found dead this morning.
Victim's employment history. Hold on. Okay, what should I be looking at in order? Okay, it's gonna be modeling job. Okay, so this is pretty much it.
Was that all you wanted?
No! Oh my god, I thought I messed up.
How long had Julia worked as a model?
Well, she worked in New York before coming here. She was a very beautiful girl.
She worked in New York before coming here? I mean...
Could you tell us why you let Miss Randall go?
Husbands sometimes come in here with their wives. When Julia Randall modeled, the husbands were often more interested in her than they were their wives' dresses. The wives weren't happy, and neither was I.
Because she was eye candy?
Did she have any close friends here?
Actually, yes. Heather Swanson. Would you like to speak with her?
No, she's here.
I'd like that very much. Please don't inform her about Miss Randall's death.
Very well, officer.
You fired her because she was eye candy?
These
are you kidding me?
From the LAPD.
I'm Detective Phelps. This is Detective Earle. I understand that you worked with Julia Randall, Miss Swanson?
Yes. Julia helped me get my job here. She's not in any kind of trouble, is
she? She's a hellraiser, isn't she? Lives a fast life.
Oh, no. Maybe Mrs. Stanley would call her that, but I wouldn't. She's full of life, a wonderful company.
That's a lovely engagement ring.
Do you like it? Henry gave it to me.
I'm very interested in engagement rings. Do you mind if I take a closer look?
He's trying to look at the ring and then compare it to, Okay.
That's some pearl, Miss Swanson. Would have cost Henry a fortune. He must really love you.
That should look ugly. A relationship with victim informed of Mr. Henderson. Wait. Mr. Henderson. We didn't get his...
Don't go away, detective. I want to know what this is about.
My fault. We didn't get Mr. Henderson's first name, right? She just said Henry. We don't know who that is.
How did you meet Julia?
I was introduced through my fiancé, Henry Garnett.
Okay, so it's not... I mean, I assume she's telling the truth.
Henry is your beau. Tell us about it.
Yes, he is. Henry has a fashion business. He and Julia have been friends for years.
Oh, yeah. I bet they've been friends for years. Informed of Mr. Henderson.
Are Miss Randall and Mr. Henderson engaged?
Who's he?
I don't think she's playing dumb. Gold ring set with 4 gained white pearls. Why did you take note of that? Gold ring set with 2 carat black sapphire gemstones.
She was wearing a sapphire engagement ring. Someone must have given it to her.
She never mentioned a man named Henderson to me.
That's all for now, Miss Swanson. Could you ask your fiancé to visit Hollywood Police Station? It would be very helpful to our inquiry.
Now, wait a moment. I don't think I'll pass on that message until you tell me why you're asking all these questions.
Julia Randall was found dead this morning.
What? Oh, no. Oh, I can't believe it. She was so full of life.
I ain't buying that bull. That freaking acting. Hold on, let me make a quick phone call. Where the phone at? She was so full of life. No, she was high on life. That's
Phelps,
what she was.
1247.
How could I help, Detective?
Are there any messages for me?
Yes, Detective. The coroner's been asking to speak to you. I can connect the call if you like.
Please, thank you.
Okay, coroner, what you got for me, bro?
Cole, can you get over here? I just finished the autopsy.
Sure thing, Mal. We'll be right over.
Investigate Hollywood Morgue. Let's go to the hospital at the police station.
Nice move not telling old Sweet Lips in there about her friend taking the big jump till we were half out the door. Very slick.
I figured we'd get more out of her that way.
Yeah.
You're learning, Phelps. We'll make a vice cop out of you yet.
All units in the vicinity and any central unit. Citizen reports a 415 at 7th and Central. Unit to handle code 2. Identify.
Thank you.
see what else this man has discovered.
Cole, Roy, I have some information for you.
Who the hell is this?
You're the only person enjoying this, Mal. Get on with it.
The bruising confirms two sets of hands, so we have two killers. Death was caused by heart failure due to an overdose of morphine.
Have you dragged us down here to gloat? We already heard your theory.
We agree that she was murdered.
Yes, of course.
I have something else to show you.
Murder, okay.
All right, Mal, what gives?
The dead guy's name is Jimmy LeBlanc, career burglar. He came in this morning. Someone stove his head in with a lump of 2x4.
So what? Good riddance.
I found two Surettes in his jacket pocket.
Wow.
Hang on a minute, Roy. We're listening now.
No sign of morphine use and no metabolized morphine in his blood. Scratch marks on his face.
Which could be from getting his head remodeled.
Time of death, Mal.
Maybe an hour or two after the Randall girl.
So you're saying Laughing Boy here could be one of our killers?
But who killed
him? That's a hell of a long shot.
Thanks, Mal. We'll check it out.
I found something else.
Jesus. What you found? Who killed this guy then? Oh my goodness. Damn, Doc, you couldn't close her eyes? Who's that, a Snicker bar?
Sorry, I don't play.
Is it harmonica?
I don't know if it's significant. His wallet was empty. The only other things he was carrying were the harmonica and the morphine.
Interesting. Interesting find.
Carruthers. Yeah, he's here. I'll send him over. They have a guy called Henry Arnett in interview 2 for you next door.
Okay, that's the...
Let me know how you get on.
Sure, Mal. And thanks for the lead.
That's the
Sure,
woman
Mal. Thanks for
interviewed.
The lead.
Fiance. I'm so sick of Roy's attitude. Like, I'm so sick of you, bro. I don't know what you have against progression in life or in your career, as a matter of fact, but, like, you need to cut that shit out.
Yeah, I want to make homicide.
Arnett is in interview 2, Phelps.
Okay.
Go help him get whatever it is off his chest.
Interview 2. So it's this way.
Advice,
okay.
Boys, get any on the side.
Interview 2, make a left. Okay. Interview. Okay. Oh, it's right in front of me. Here we go.
Mr. Arnett, I'm Detective Phelps. This is Detective Earl. Thanks for coming in.
Call me Henry.
Oh, you're a handsome young man.
It's the least I could do. Terrible news about Julia.
What if he's the second man?
That's correct.
I mean, it would make sense, you know, easy to get into her place. But then again, we don't know about this Mr. Henderson guy.
How well did you know Julia Randall?
Vaguely. I'm in the clothing business, and Julia occasionally modeled for me.
That's not what your girlfriend, well, your fiance said. She said that you guys have been friends for years. Now, this could be Mr. Henderson's jacket.
And you were close? We were friends.
Shit.
Miss Randall's landlady said she was seeing an older man.
Could have been. I wasn't privy to all the details of Julia's private life.
Has anyone seen my pen?
No. Spill it, Henry! You know nothing about a man named Henderson?
Yes, you're right. Henderson, yeah. Very distinguished.
How about a first name, wise guy?
Yeah, we do.
An address, maybe?
We need a first name.
I'm sorry, I don't. I think he lives somewhere out of town. Somewhere back east.
San Francisco? How was that wrong, bro? I low-key got something out of him, just not what we was looking for. Burglary suspect LeBlanc?
Ever heard of a Jimmy LeBlanc?
No. Should I have? Is he an entertainer or something?
Can you bring me the file?
So you wouldn't have any reason to believe that LeBlanc would be involved in Julie Randall's murder?
If this guy is a criminal, he might have been involved. But like I said, I've never heard of this LeBlanc character.
Why are you smoking?
Heather told us that you were in fashion.
That's right.
Don't hand me your card, bro. I'm not looking for a job.
And he still confessed.
Director.
Some kind of traveling salesman?
Once I got out of the Corps, I used my...
You were in the Marines?
Sure. I'm proud of it. The Fighting Sixth.
You were in the Sixth Marines?
Yes. I was a captain.
Which company?
Okay, Captain America.
Various companies. We had a lot of casualties.
Which engagements?
Okinawa. A couple of other places.
That will be all for now, Henry. You've been very helpful.
That son of a bitch was never in the Marines.
Yeah.
Why'd you let him off the hook?
I don't think he was either.
Because we're giving him a couple of minutes before we start tailing him. Arnett is an amateur. We need to find out who killed the girl. Can you pass this on to Bukowski? Have him check the place out and go through his records.
Sure, I'll pass it on.
Thanks. Can you also have R&I run the records on a Jimmy LeBlanc and find out who was his last arresting officer? Have him get in touch via KGPL when they have some information.
LeBlanc. That is such an interesting name.
He's in that car at the lights.
Why are you sitting like that? Okay.
He was squirming like a worm in there. Don't you love it when they pull the war hero excuse? Actually, maybe you don't.
I mean, it is a little bit offended if you lie about being in the war to someone that actually been in the war. So I can understand how Cole is gonna take that, you know, to the heart. Oh, finally. Ugly ass suit. Yep, he definitely hiding something. Who runs across the street? Is that his fiance? That is.
He needs money.
We have no roof over our car. They can see us. Y'all don't see us?
Get in there and find out what he pawned. I'll stick with him. See how he intends to spend the money. Too much slack. Gotta get closer.
Puff it, Phelps. I'll bring the car around when I'm done here.
That was his fiance outside waiting for him, right? I'm pretty sure it was. Oh gosh, I hate this following mess.
Move in. Can't risk losing the trail.
Whoa! Easy! What are you doing?
Nothing, bro.
Too much slack.
I'm just reading the newspaper.
Slack. Gotta get closer.
Where'd he go? He went in the store? Oh, there he is. Got drunk? That's how they came out the store?
That's right, Mexico City. One-way ticket, please.
Oh, not you trying to leave town.
That would be one day from now. Is that okay?
It's going to have to be.
You trying to leave town? One-way ticket?
LAPD, the man who just came in here, he bought a ticket?
Yes, sir, to Mexico City, tomorrow night.
If you hear from him again, don't mention this conversation.
You know, he's ditching his fiance.
What have you got?
He bought a ticket from Mexico City. Tomorrow night.
That's good. But this is better.
What you got? Train ticket. What's this?
My God. It's Fabergé.
Should have seen the look on the pawnbroker's face when I told him to hand it over.
Can I open it?
The guy who owned the joint thought it was worth at least 10 large for a cigarette case.
Arnett
only got
case?
600 clams.
I can't read cursive. Dearest Beverly, with love and affection. I can't read cursive that well. Is that an A? Is that in my notes, please? Gold, Neiman Faberge, case value, that's, ooh, 10,000, Jesus. That's money, honey, that's money. All right, we gotta go make a phone call. I still believe he is. Oh wait, that's.
Go ahead, KGPL.
11K, go to Hollywood Station. Homicide detectives Bukowski and Galloway have information relating to the Randall case.
Roger, KGPL. 11K, en route.
Car 11K, car 11K.
Oh my God, you're just so popular.
Car
right
11
now.
King, go ahead.
R&I reports the last arresting officer for DOA Jimmy LeBlanc was Patrolman Fred Wallace, who's working a shift on Hollywood 9th Beat, Sunset Boulevard between Gordon and Wilcox.
Car 11K, en route.
Man, we got so much to get to. Okay, okay. So the officer that we wanted to look for was the last arresting officer for that guy that died, just to keep you guys in the loop of what's going on here. Jimmy LeBlanc, okay. Jimmy LeBlanc, the guy that died. Where should we go first? Should we go to the police station, or should we go speak to the officer that knows Jimmy LeBlanc? Or should we meet up with our previous partners? No, because he's on shifts, and I don't know how long he's going to be on shifts. So let's go and talk to this officer. What's his name? Officer Fred Wallace. I still believe this man is the second,
Mexico.
You know, guy
Old
that
Henry's
murdered
looking as guilty
woman,
as a dog
man.
Next to a pile of dog shit.
What's his motive?
I can think of a few, but I'd put my money south of the belt. One guy plus two dames? Always equals problems.
Mm-hmm. What the hell is going on here?
Come on, let's give him a hand.
Damn, you almost...
Right behind you, Wallace. Detective Phelps.
Right behind you, Wallace. Like, you come out of nowhere. I'm on
Wallace,
the ass too,
go
Wallace.
Left. I'm going right after this little prick in the alley.
Watch out. Wallace, put the pedal to the metal, bro. Gosh, you need a coal in your life. Ooh. I would shoot, but I don't want to kill him. Ooh. Look at this guy. My hat! Once again, you guys, continuously shoot off my hat.
I'm wide open here.
How long do you think you can hold out?
Get behind something, Phelps.
I'm good, bro. I don't need no defense.
Thanks. Outstanding warrant, armed robbery. Knocked over a drugstore back there, and it looks like he brought his whole posse with him. Bad luck for them.
They're all yours now. We need some information.
Ever heard of a burglar goes by the name of Jimmy LeBlanc?
Sure. I nabbed Jimmy on a burglary beef a couple of years back. They cut through a music shop and into a jewelry store. He got 4 years.
Mm.
I miss his partner, though.
His partner?
Who's his partner?
Big guy.
Uh-huh.
I had him cornered, and he picked up this huge display case and threw it out a plate glass window. Then he vaulted out of there like something out of Barnum and Bailey.
Got away.
I would have had him, except for LeBlanc yelling, "Run for it, Willie."
Willie.
You think he was an acrobat of some sort?
More like a strongman, a wrestler, or a boxer, that kind of thing.
Thanks. You've been a big help.
You haven't done too badly yourself.
You don't got no partner? That's what I'm saying. Who the hell is Willie, bro? Who the hell is Willie? It could be a nickname.
You're suggesting LeBlanc is still working with Willie?
A strong man held down Randall while someone administered the morphine. Someone with muscle opened up LeBlanc's skull.
Mm-hmm.
Could be.
Bro, it's that freaking man. I can't remember his name right now, but I know it's him. Willie could just be his nickname or like a name you say so that you don't get give off your identity. Hollywood Police Station, 6:32 p.m.
We caught up with Mal. He's given us the dope on LeBlanc. He worked burglaries with a big guy. Goes by the name of Willie. He might be our killer. Can you work boxing gyms, the Y, promoters, that kind of stuff?
Since when have you started giving orders, Phelps?
Oh, my gosh.
And where's the burglary angle? There was no sign of a...
That's where our net comes in. Next stop, we speak to Lacey about a list of recent burglaries.
The guy's a bum. His office is a front, and he's behind on the rent and his phone bill.
And he's skipping town tomorrow.
Let's get him in and beat it out of him.
Do you want to bring in the killer, Rusty?
It could be too smart for your own good, Phelps. We've been talking about that, haven't we, Roy? Stefan?
Finbar?
Y'all talking about me behind my back? What the hell?
Item stolen over the last year.
Hang on, I'll dig out a copy.
They just jealous, bro. They just jealous.
Here you go.
Thanks.
Is the cigarette case on there?
What are we looking for? Hold on. What are we looking for? I'm sorry. Inspect recent burglary list from Watch Commander. Sure. I need the contraband list. Items stolen over the last year. Okay.
Thing was, he was a real nice
radio station,
guy.
Gold cigarette, black sapphire ring.
Julia Randall's ring.
Yeah.
It's here.
Gold chain, diamond brooch, gold and emerald earrings, coin collection, silver pill, crystal drinking glass. Gold candelabra, Bible, a watch, assortment, bond, pearl ring? Pearl ring?
Even the engagement ring was purloined. Arnett is a cad.
What case? Is there something on the back, or am I missing something? Cigarette case. I didn't even see that.
Arnett must be out of his mind trying to move this while under a murder cloud.
Wow. Is that it? Investigate Everstone residence. Oh, Mrs. Everstone. Contraband list. So he stole the cigarette box and tried to pawn it off for money. He tried to wipe his hands clean. And apparently he's behind on his rent. That's hilarious. I knew that suit was a knockoff. Listed address of burglary victims, Beverly Everstone.
So you and Rusty have been having discussions.
That's what I'm saying. Let's talk about it.
To tell me, partner?
Phelps, don't be so touchy. Rusty had his best ever clearance rate working with you. Even if the cases he worked on can't be discussed. We were just comparing notes.
About me? For what, though?
You're a Boonaroo case man, Phelps. One of the best I've ever seen.
Thanks.
Nah,
you gotta
that.
Learn to take a compliment, Phelps.
Not from you guys. My fault.
Any sentry unit.
Everstone residence, 6:53 p.m.
LAPD, ma'am. Is Mrs. Evestrom in?
She is. Would you follow me, sir?
Is that her playing the piano?
I am Mrs. Evestrom. How may I help you?
Hello.
You appear to have recovered some stolen goods that belong to
you. Oh, it belonged to her.
Yes, of course. That terrible burglary. Would you like something to drink?
No, thank you, ma'am. We have some questions, if you don't mind.
Why would I mind, young man? If you are returning 43 pieces of my property.
Okay, before we get down to that, I'll have a scotch. Thanks, straight up.
Maria, can you get the detective a drink, please?
Straight up! I just had to say it. List of stolen items. Wealthy burglary victim.
Can you describe to us what was stolen?
It would be easier to describe what wasn't stolen, Detective. A priceless tiara that has been in the family for 50 years. A Fabergé cigarette case
that
was worth $25,000.
That's not what it says in our notes, but that's a lie. Look at her trying to, like... Hold on. Before I say it's a lie, does it matter, though? Does it matter? Does it matter that she said 25 instead of 10? I'm gonna say lie.
Why are you lying about the value of your jewelry, Mrs. Evstrom?
It does.
Who do you think you are, making heinous accusations in my own home?
It's worth 10,000, ma'am. Stop it.
We recovered the cigarette case from a pawnbroker. No one knows the real value of an item better than those guys.
I inflated its value for the insurance claim.
I bet you did.
There. Are you satisfied? My daughter's boyfriend was quite taken with the case. I think he was even more disappointed than I was when it was stolen.
I'm sorry to hear that. Burglary incident report.
What can you tell us about the burglary?
That terrible night, at least a year ago. But let's not go into that. Let's talk about what you've recovered.
Why are you... No, I'm asking you questions. Let's not go into that. Damn, I can't even look at that. List of stolen items prohibited to trade covering 12-month period. I'm gonna just say doubt.
I get the sense that you're worried about something, Mrs. Evstrom.
I have already received the insurance claim, Detective. Is there any way we could keep the return of these items discreet?
Why?
That's about it for now, Mrs. Evstrom. The department will get in touch and let you know how you can recover your valuables.
You have only mentioned a few of the items that have been stolen, Detective. What else has been recovered?
You see, Phelps, that's why you get the drinks in early.
Hello, Mother. Hello, detectives.
Oh, I'm spot on. Yes. I amaze myself sometimes. Wow. Her boyfriend, her fiance now, he stole it. He is the other half of that of Jimmy, whatever his last name is. Wow.
What is going on?
We'd like to ask exactly the same question.
You have met my daughter?
Wow.
This morning at work.
Small world.
Oh, mother and father divorced. I took my father's name.
The detectives recovered some of the things that were stolen.
She know, though.
What did you find?
She knows.
A sapphire
she know.
Ring.
She knows. She knows.
And the corpse
she know.
Of Julia Randall.
What are you talking about?
Your engagement ring, Miss Swanson. Would you be surprised to know that it was part of the proceeds of a burglary?
That's an outrageous allegation.
Yes, it is. I suggest we go straight to Henry Arnett's place and sort this mess out.
Yes. Oh, sit in the back seat. You cool back there? I bet. I cool. You want to hear some music? Nah. Let's go. Where are we going? Arnett's apartment? Hurry. Let's go. You can just sit there and look pretty.
We're missing something here. Arnett is obviously arranging the burglaries.
That's my fiance you're making scurrilous
Shut
accusations
up.
About.
And Randall was obviously his partner.
But neither of them are the type to creep apartments.
You're being ridiculous. Both of you. There's a very good explanation for all of this.
Put a sock in it, sister. You're being played for a pet.
What the?
Phelps!
Oh, please keep talking. Oh my gosh. I ruined the conversation! Arnett's apartment, 7:26 p.m. Alright. What floor does
Come
he live on?
Come on, sister. Let's find out who your fiancé really is.
Bro, she knows.
Welcome, sir. I'm sorry, are you a resident?
No, I'm a cop.
LAPD detectives. We're here to speak to Henry Arnett.
Oh, Mr. Arnett? Apartment 30. You can take the lift.
Thank you.
You didn't even ask for a badge, bro. How you know I didn't just lie?
Well, isn't this just nice and awkward?
Stop! LAPD!
Don't kill him, Cole. This guy's our case.
I wasn't gonna shoot him. I wasn't gonna shoot him, but like, saying that stop, I'll shoot would probably, you know, stop
him.
Give
it up, LAPD.
Go down. Where'd he go?
Don't make me chase you.
Too late. If I could shoot him, I would. No. Come on. Here we go. You're good. Who's this? This is Willie. It's gotta be Willie. His face literally just says Willie.
Looks like he got you good, Phelps.
Yeah, he really packs a wallop.
Damn, he got away.
How'd I get back here?
Under your own steam, miraculously. You came in through the window, said hello, and then keeled over.
How was Arnett?
He's coming around, too. He's all hopped up. Good time to get some answers.
You missing something, Henry?
Packing, huh? Where you going? Mexico, was it?
You told Heather you're honeymooning without her?
You wasn't even gonna take her with you. That's hilarious. I'm gonna take a look around. It's a nice little fan.
It would take a smarter man than me to connect that. Don't think this is anything.
Okay. What is that?
Incidental.
Incidental? What is this? A tea bag? What is that? Oh, that's a mirror. Okay. It's a nice place you got here. Very roomy. You got a lot of rooms. It says flashlight.
Seems irrelevant.
Okay. Got some watermelon. If I was black, I would think this is racist, but okay. All right, it doesn't seem like there's really anything here for me to really look at, so let's just get with the questioning. Professional burglary ring.
We know all about the jewelry ring. You and Randall and LeBlanc and Willie doing the legwork.
I'm in the fashion business.
Now, we both know that's not true, man. We both know that, but how can I prove that? Is it the contraband list? Is it that? Or is it this? Because... It's either this or this, but I don't know which one.
You're lying, Henry.
How can you prove that I'm involved, detective?
Okay, just by him saying that, I know. We can choose a cigarette case.
Because you pawned a Fabergé cigarette case today for $600.
Damn, you only got $600?
A case that is on a list of stolen items.
It was Julia's idea.
Julia?
get a list of society parties and find out where and when.
Look at her face. She wants to slap him so bad.
Julia was desperate for money. No matter how much we made, she always wanted more.
Look at her face! You got anything to say about that, Julia? No? All right. Motive for Randall murder.
Why did Reed and LeBlanc kill Julia Randall?
I wanted to stop, to get out of that life. I was going to marry Heather if she'd have me. Julia told the others that they were out, that she was going to create a new gang.
Let me read this log one more time. Okay, why did Reed LeBlanc kill Julia Randall? I want to stop to get out of that life. I was going to marry Heather if she'd have me. Julia told the others that they were out. That she was going to create a new gang. Wait, her name's not Julia. Her name's Heather. I'm confusing the women. If he's lying, how can I prove that? We still haven't met this Henderson guy. He lucky he out of town. I mean, he not lying. He bought a ticket, but he only bought one ticket.
But why kill her?
She always looked down on those two. When she told them that she was cutting them out, they swore to get even with her.
Oh, God, I got it wrong. Identity of Mr. Henderson.
Who is Henderson, and what is his involvement?
Tell them what you know, Henry. I'll stand by you if you'll only tell the truth.
There is no Henderson.
There is a Henderson. Hold on now. Because we got the freaking maid statement. Where is that at? I'm sorry, the housekeeper statement. Unless she was lying. And then it was... Well, I can't really say that because...
Tell me about your first burglary. And don't lie.
I can't remember. I don't keep a list of these things.
You can't remember. You don't keep a list of these things. It's a good thing we do.
Your first burglary was a Dr. Harold Stoneman. Do you want to explain how he is involved, or shall I?
Henderson is Stoneman. He was crazy about Julia. She could get him to do whatever she wished. He threw the parties, and we arranged
the
burglaries.
The prescription guy.
Julia never let him touch her. She just kept him hanging on the promise.
The prescription guy!
The doctor almost insane.
Henry Arnett, you are under arrest for burglary and for the murder of Julia Randall.
Henderson is Stoneman, all right? I'm not the guy you want. Go talk to the good doctor.
Oh, we will, knucklehead. Meanwhile, we're fitting you for convict stripes.
All right, Heather, you could go. My fault. I don't know. I just thought that she had some type of involvement. I was getting her name mixed up with Julia. Damn. But she's, like, still, though. Her faces, she was appalled. She was flabbergasted. All right, let's go talk to the good old doctor. Yep. I feel like I'd be changing my favorite cases so often. I guess
the wedding's off.
I think this one is my favorite case.
They only robbed her mother and killed her best friend. Cut the guy some slack.
What are you
no!
doing? So how does the doctor fit in?
That's what we're about to find out. Maybe we should ask him to give you a quick once-over. That meathead gave you one hell of a pasting.
I've had worse.
You should have seen yourself staggering back in there like a drunken sailor.
Next time you can take the runner, Roy.
I didn't box in the Marines, though, did I?
I should have never told you that.
I ain't gonna lie, Roy did call it out, saying that he sounded relieved that she has passed. He did call it. Is this his car? It is like 505, right? I think so. Come on, Roy.
Time for the doctor to give us something to make this all better.
Very funny.
Hang on a moment, sister. Tell him it's Henry Arnett, and tell him it's urgent.
I can't do that.
Tell him, or I'll charge you with obstruction of justice.
Doctor, I'm afraid Mr. Arnett is here to see you, and he says it's urgent.
Send him in.
Oh, yeah. I'm gonna send him in, all right.
I told you never to come. Tell us the truth, Doctor.
Why can't we just open the freaking door? Well, we had a...
I'm so glad you came. Prison will be better than insanity, and I'm already half insane with grief.
What?
Do you know that I loved her?
No, did you?
I ruined my life for her, and yet I still love her.
Will you testify in court that Arnett and Randall did these robberies?
Why are you here?
They organized the robberies. Julie would get the names of the guests attending my wife's parties. Didn't matter how much money I showered upon her, it was never enough. She never really cared for me.
Doctor, I'm afraid you're under arrest.
Why are you here?
Oh, the practice. You'll call Dr. Gerard. No, please don't cry. I want to see no one. Not my wife, or my children, nor my friends. And I don't want a lawyer. Just lock me up and throw away the key.
I thought he would like...
What have I done?
Okay.
Didn't see that coming.
I was about to say, I thought he would put up more of a fight. We didn't even get to question him. Where the phone at?
Operator, give me dispatch.
Putting you through now.
I need an ambulance and the coroner immediately to the offices of Dr. Harold Stoneman, 1646 Ivor Street, Hollywood.
En route, Detective. You have a message. Detective Bukowski says the suspect is named Wilson Willie the Wolf Reed, former wrestler. Last known address is an apartment building at the corner of Hollywood and Vine. Detective Bukowski says to meet them there.
Got you.
On our way.
You know what else is going to be on its
way? We have an address for the runner.
Freaking Let's try lunch, and wrap this man. Up, I'm then. I'm hungry. Hold on, y'all.
That old boy really fell for that broad.
Yep.
She was incredibly beautiful, boy.
Would you throw it all away for a woman?
Life has a way of making you pay for your pride.
You're quite the romantic, Phelps. Stick with the percentages. Broken hearts are for chumps.
You're talking from experience.
I certainly am. Oh, I like women as much as the next guy. As long as they're in their place and doing what they're told.
Shut up, bro. Willie's apartment. 1 a.m.
He's around here somewhere. A big guy. Neighbors say he always wears basketball shoes and a cream jacket. And get this. The kids around here say he plays the harmonica.
Find the game well and have the commander set up a dragnet. We want the area closed off. We'll take this out of the street.
Okay.
A harmonica playing wrestler. That's a weird one. Think he knits as well?
Oh my gosh.
Just keep your eyes open and your mouth shut. We don't want him to bolt on us.
You hear that? I do. Keep on playing. Yep. Here he is. Willie!
Wilson Reed, LAPD, give yourself up.
Oh my God. I just hate how they're just so prepared, man. Every time. Oh, he went up? My fault. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, Roy. Your ass cheeks, bro. Come on now. Smell like nothing but freaking sloppy joes. Jump. I got a present for you? Since when?
We're not the only one in the street.
We're all trying to get somewhere.
Went up. Let me go first.
Hold it. He's got to be around here somewhere. No place to go unless he grew wings. There he is. Waste the son of a bitch.
Waste him? Really? It's like some rush hour shit. There's no way he's eating all these bullets to the freaking back, bro. Come on, Willie. Oh, nice shot, Roy. I saw that. That was like to the neck.
Son of a bitch really picked a spot for it up here, didn't he? Julia Randall's folks are flying in from New York tomorrow to claim the body. I saw her on the slab. So perfect. Looked like she was made of porcelain. She really made an impression on me.
Okay.
Julia had that impact on a lot of men.
Christ, it's cold. You guys did good work here today. Roy, I think you should buy your brother officers a drink.
Do you now? That's very generous of you, Lieutenant.
Eight million stories. I feel like I didn't do too bad on this one. The slightest trace of morphine at the crime scene would have to put a smile on Caruthers' face. All right, y'all. That wraps up with today's L.A. Noire case of another Vice case. If you guys enjoyed that video, make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe, and all that good stuff. And I'll see you guys in the next video, which will most likely be recorded right after this one, because I'm gonna still keep playing. I'm gonna just have me some lunch first. See y'all, man. See y'all.